Kidding.
Here comes our general manager.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the general manager for Raw, Eric Bischoff.
You know, this Batista is becoming an enigma. I can't quite figure him, and I don't think Triple H can either.
Well, he's a team player, that's obvious. He's going to stick by Triple H, stick by Evolution. You just heard it, plain and simple.
Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce to you one of my greatest creations, the Elimination Chamber. Over 10 tons of steel and chain, designed to be one of the most punishing environments any professional athlete could ever compete in. And where tonight, one of six Raw superstars will become the next heavyweight champion of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of everyone at WWE, welcome to New Year's Revolution.
It's all about becoming the world's heavyweight champion. And to do it, you gotta be willing to put your career, your body on the line inside this demonic structure. 16 feet in diameter, 2 miles of chain were used to construct this thing. It's 16 feet from the roof to the floor with a weight of over 10 tons.
The rules of the Elimination Chamber match are as follows. Two participants will start the match. At the end of 5 minutes, a chamber will open where another participant will enter the match. This will continue until all the participants are involved. At any time during the match, someone can be eliminated by pinfall or submission and must leave the chamber. This will go on until we have a winner who will be the new World Heavyweight Champion.
I think I'm key. I know I'm sexy. I've got the looks. They drive so cool while
I'm. And here, gentlemen, comes the wild card in this whole equation.
I said chill up and down their spine. I'm just a sexy woman.
My God, what an ovation.
Please welcome your special guest referee, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
Well, no doubt everyone here in Puerto Rico seems to love HBK, but one thing's for certain, not one participant in this Elimination Chamber match liked the idea of Shawn Michaels being the referee tonight.
We saw Heartbreak Kid earlier tonight tell Ed he's going to call it right down the middle. I, for one, don't believe Shawn Michaels for a second.
One of the all-time greats, ladies and gentlemen, a Hall of Famer, one of the greatest in-ring performers in 30 years I have ever seen. And boy, oh boy, do they love him in Puerto Rico. Wherever you're watching, we thank you for inviting us to your home. Over 150 countries watching New Year's Revolution. 15,000 plus selling out Coliseum D, Puerto Rico.
You think you know me?
First, from Toronto, Canada, weighing in at 250 pounds, Ed!
Ed tried to negotiate his way out of this match earlier, trying to make the deal with Chris. And why? Why? All because of Shawn Michaels' involvement.
That's exactly right. Ed doesn't feel like he has a chance, and I don't blame him. If I'm Ed, I don't want to be in this either, but now he is, so Ed has got to make the most of it.
Well, number one, you're not Ed. Number two, I trust Shawn Michaels' integrity. And number three, I think Ed is nothing but paranoid. Well, he's never been the world's champion. He got a chance to be the world's champion. You don't turn down that opportunity.
Well, he deserves to be the world heavyweight champion, and maybe, just maybe, tonight is Edge's night. Well,
Uh-oh, look at this. Shawn Michaels directing Edge to his personal chamber. Actually, I think Edge has about the same chance as everybody else in this match when it comes to Shawn Michaels, because Shawn Michaels doesn't like anybody that's in this match. And nobody in this match likes Shawn Michaels.
Look at the chain in there. They're chaining Edge in there like some kind of an animal in this elimination chamber.
And that surprises you?
No, I know how it goes, but it just...
Shawn Michaels say how much he'd enjoy counting Edge out. He would delight in counting Triple H out. You know he would.
You got that right.
Now listen to this ovation.
From St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 260 pounds, Randy Orton.
The third generation 44-year-old Randy Orton realized his dream of becoming the world champion at SummerSlam. And finally, Randy Orton is back in the hunt. Look at that glass in between them. Randy Orton. The deal went down that as long as Triple H was the world champion, that Randy Orton would never get another world title shot. Orton agreed to the terms, but the time is vacant. Orton is in the hunt. He is a hungry dog looking for some gold.
And he too, like everybody else, must be put in his chamber, and there's nothing Randy Orton can do until that chamber door is open for him.
Chain that hungry dog up right now. On a former Evolution member, a man that has one chamber, Evolution chamber match, under his belt. He does look like a hungry dog.
The intensity that all these men are showing to me is absolutely amazing tonight.
You could be looking at the next heavyweight champion of the world, ladies and gentlemen.
From Washington, D.C., weighing in at 318 pounds, Batista.
Batista is an F-O-N, a freak of nature, 6 feet 5, 318 pounds. Evolution's animal. And he will be released from his chamber last.
And if Batista didn't have an advantage before because of being a freak of nature.
Wow. Well, Randy Orton asked Batista the right question earlier on,
And Batista had the right answer. If he gets the shot, he will be the World Heavyweight Champion tonight.
Batista's never won the World's Heavyweight title. Will this be the night?
Boy, I'd hate to be in an Elimination Chamber match, but I'd even hate it worse if Batista was in it.
I'm telling you guys, I don't think that's going to happen. Batista's a team player, and he knows what his job is here tonight in this Elimination Chamber match.
Well, you may be right, but let's don't forget, Batista's also got a family to feed. And becoming the World's Heavyweight Champion is the greatest honor.
Look at Orton. He just reminded Batista, use your head.
Use your head and do the job. Do the job you're in there to do.
Yeah, but he said don't be a stooge for Triple H.
Batista does not like being caged. Four men have entered their personal chamber. Batista, Triple H, along with Randy Orton. And Edge, ladies and gentlemen, and look at Edge's face. Is this his night to make history?
I'm worried about Edge. He looked the least confident there to me. I hope you're not implying that the game is not.
Oh, they all are.
There you go.